In part two of this lecture, we will continue to look at the different blood groups and their distribution. So if you look at blood group A, they are more common in the North America region, namely Canada, the Scandinavian countries, and Australia, with a percentage of about 35 up to 40%. Whereas in the South America, blood type A is very rare, which is about 0 to 5%. As for blood group B, it is even more interesting because you can hardly see them in the whole American continent and Australia. But blood group B or the LLB is more prominent in the Central Asia region, especially in India, with 25 up to 30%. And how about blood group O? Well, it is the most common blood group all over the world. In South America, you have about 90 to 100% of the population having the blood type O, and the lowest being in the Central Asia, which is still about 50 to 60%. Okay, here is a quick comparison. In Malaysia, the most commonly found blood group is blood group O at 34.5%, and the same goes to UK but at 46%. But in Finland, the most common blood group is blood group B at 38%, while AB is the rarest group for all different countries here. Speaking of glycoproteins A, B, and H, these are all antigens that can elicit antibody production. So for individuals that do not have antigen A or B on their own red blood cells, then they will develop antibodies against these antigens, even though they have not been exposed to this blood type beforehand. Why is it so? That's because antigen A and B are very widespread in nature, and you can even find them in the gut bacteria. So for newborn babies, they can develop these antibodies very soon as they interact with the external world. But of course, if the babies are having these antigens themselves on their red blood cells, then they will not develop antibodies to attack their own blood cells. So now we can add one more column to the table just now. For blood group A, you have antibody against blood group B. For blood group B, you have antibody against blood group A. For blood group AB, you will not have any antibody, but for blood group O, you have antibody towards blood group A and B. So please take note that blood group antigens are also known as agglutinogens, while the antibody raised against these antigens are known as agglutinins. So in this table, you basically have the same thing that I have just mentioned, so I'm not going to repeat again. Now, if you go back to the lady that we talked at the start of this lecture, she had blood group O, but she was transfused with blood group A. So what happens here is that she had both antibody against blood group A and blood group B. So the newly transfused blood group A will be clumped together by this antibody against blood group A, followed by the hemolysis or the breakdown of the red blood cells. And this condition caused by the incompatible blood transfusion is known as the hemolytic transfusion reaction, which is most often the result of procedural or human error. On the other hand, the donated blood will also contain some amount of antibodies that can potentially agglutinate or clump the recipient's red blood cells. However, this is less significant because the donated blood along with the antibodies are quickly diluted by the recipient's blood, which is much larger in volume. So, what are the clinical relevance of the ABO blood group? Well, we have to perform blood transfusion in great care to avoid the hemolytic transfusion reaction from happening. However, it is always safe with persons with blood group AB because these are the universal recipients, which means they can receive blood from anyone else. For patients with blood group O, on the other hand, these are universal donors, which means their blood can be donated to anyone else. This is because blood group A, B, and O do not possess antibodies against the H antigen. Remember, the H antigen presents in all types of blood groups. So which one do you like to be? Is it a universal recipient or a universal donor? Okay, there is another clinically important blood group, which is the rhesus group or the rhesus factor. So the name rhesus is after the monkeys in which they were first discovered. And there are 49 rhesus antigens which can be found on the surface of the red blood cells. But the most important and the most common one is D antigen or the D agglutinogen. So a person can be either a rhesus D positive or D negative. So for individuals who are homozygous dominant or heterozygous dominant, you are D positive. But for individuals who are homozygous recessive, then they are rhesus D negative. So speaking of gene distribution, almost all Asians, or 99%, we have the D antigen on our red blood cells. But for Caucasians, that figure is 85%, which means 15% of Caucasians, they are lacking the D antigen on their red blood cells. So there's one important difference between the D factor and the antigen A and B of the ABO blood group. That is, the antibodies against the D antigen are not normally produced by sensitization to the environmental antigens, which unlike the AP antigen, in which we may develop antibodies against antigen A or antigen B through our exposure to the environment, such as the gut bacteria. But it is safer to assume that a person with D negative blood type will develop antibody against the D antigen, and therefore they will destroy any D positive red blood cells that they come into contact with. So with this in mind, here we have the updated red blood cell compatibility table. So if the donor is O negative, then his blood has no antigen and it can be received by any other recipients. So O negative in this case is the real universal donor. On the other hand, AB positive is the real universal recipient because this person will receive blood from all other blood group systems without any trouble. Aside from blood transfusion, rhesus factor is one important consideration during pregnancy, and it is something that we must pay attention. That's because during birth, there is often some leakage of the baby's red blood cell into the mother's circulation. So if the baby is RhD positive, while the mother is RhD negative, then the baby red blood cells will cause the mother to be sensitized and to develop antibodies against the D antigen. And these antibodies are normally of the IgG class. So that will be fine for the firstborn as it will not cause any trouble. But subsequently, if the mom is pregnant again with a positive, Rh-positive baby, these antibodies will cross the placenta and attack the red blood cells of the newborn babies or the fetus. So this can destroy the red blood cells, causing anemia and jaundice, or sometimes it could just kill the fetus in the womb. So what is the solution? Well, the treatment is that all Rh negative mother will be given the antibody against the D antigen, which is known as the anti-D immunoglobulin, during the third trimester, and that will remove all the fetal D positive antigen from her circulation before the mother can make any of these antibodies against the D antigen. And this antibody, anti-D immunoglobulin, is also known as the RhoGAM. Okay, here is basically the same thing. If a mother is having a D negative blood type and is pregnant with a D positive baby for the first time, then the mother is going to be sensitized by the D positive antigen, as there will always be fetal maternal blood transfer during labor. As a result, the mother is now developing IgG antibody against the D antigen. And during her next pregnancy with a D positive baby, the IgG is going to be produced in large quantity and they can cross the placenta, marking the red blood cells for destruction. So in a mild case, the baby might just develop some jaundice or anemia, while in a severe case, that could actually kill the baby or even the fetus right in the womb. So here is how a baby with jaundice looks like. You can see increased bilirubin production, which is reflected by the yellowish tone, because remember, bilirubin is the breakdown product from hemoglobin as they are tagged by the IgG for destruction. So we have just discussed about the incompatibility issues in between the mother and the fetus. in the case that they have different D factor. But how about issues with the ABO blood group system for the pregnant woman? Well, the mother may make antibodies towards the baby ABO antigens, but these antibodies are of the IgM class and they do not cross the placenta, and therefore fetus are protected from such harm. But the keyword here is IgM. But for research factor, it is IgG. So unlike IgG that is very small and single unit, IgM is a pentamer because it contains of 5 antibody units. So because of the big size, it can't really cross the placenta, and therefore they create no harm against the baby. Aside from the ABO blood growth system, the research factors, we also have other sorts of antigens on the surface of the red blood cells, such as the Lewis family, the P family antigen, and the Forstmann antigen. Now, the common thing is for antigens, you have variability with the surface oligosaccharides. You can see different types of sugars are attached on the surface of the antigen, and with that, they will induce different sort of antibody generation. And according to Wikipedia, there are at least 35 different types of antigens, but they are less important simply because they are less likely to cause any trouble during blood transfusion. Okay, these are 5 interesting facts on your blood type and how it's related to your health. Number 1, if you have blood type AB, you are more prone to cognitive impairment. Number 2, sorry again, blood type AB, your risk of getting stomach cancer is about 26% higher than your friends with blood type B or blood type O. Number 3, if you have blood type O, you have increased risk of stomach ulcers. Number 4, type O again, that may lower your risk of getting heart disease by up to 23%. So that is a good news. Or number 5, type O again, you are 37% less likely to develop pancreatic cancer. So from the previous slide, it seems that blood group O is the best, or is it so? So sharing here, I have research findings on mosquito bites. Apparently mosquitoes, they are more attracted to blood group O than the rest of the blood types. As you can see that they receive the highest number of bites. So there are pros and cons for each blood group. To summarize, can you work out the answers for these 3 statements? Please pause the video for a while. Okay, number 1, blood groups are determined by sugars or the surface sugars that modify the surface antigens on red blood cells. Number 2, 2 clinically important blood groups are the ABO blood group and the rhesus groups. And number 3, incompatible blood transfusion causes hemolytic transfusion reaction.